What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 55 of the Ultimate Let's Play Pokemon Brilliant Diamond. Last time, we beat Cynthia and got the championship of the Sinnoh League. And after we've beaten the main storyline, we got dragged all the way out here to Snow Point City. Apparently, we're supposed to be catching a ship of some kind. And I still have my championship team with me here. And usually when I get to this point of the game, I've decided that who I'm going to be using for the championships. I tend to stick with the same team for the remainder of the game. So I probably won't be changing Pokemon or doing anything crazy like that anytime soon. Also, only the chosen man to the Snow Point Temple. I'm sorry, but you'll have to leave. So I guess we can't go in there yet. I think we need a full Pokedex in order to get in there. I think. But I'll have to make that determination as another time. Right now, I'm trying to find Barry. Well, here's the ship. What is it? Do you want to set sail to the battle zone? I guess this is what Barry was talking about. So sure. Aye aye then, let's set sail. So we're heading to a new area called the battle zone now that we are the Sinnoh League champion. Let's see where this takes us. There's one fast ship. Ah, there's Barry. Oh, hey, T.U.G. What took you so long? I'm fining you $100 million. I dare you. I really dare you. Listen up, I'm going to become the greatest trainer ever. That's why I'm here. To tough it up myself and my Pokemon. Who's this? Sorry, I couldn't help overhearing that. But the greatest trainer ever? That's going to be really tough because you're talking about me. To prove it, I'm going to the volcano right now. You look puzzled. You really don't know anything, do you? Alright, I'll tell you. This is the battle zone, okay? At its far end is a volcano, and deep inside that volcano, there's supposed to be a treasure. So what's the big deal? I'll find the treasure first, and that'll make me the greatest trainer ever? Then that's what I'll do, T.U.G. And you too, stranger. That treasure is mine. But before that, I'm going to the battle tower. See ya. That guy just can't stay put, can he? Anyways. Howdy, I'm Buck. And if that punk thinks he can beat me, he's got another thing coming. So you know that zippity-dippity trainer? You should chase after the guy and tell him not to underestimate the volcano. Oh, but you know what? You better shape up at the battle tower first. I don't like your chances of getting to the volcano otherwise. Be seeing you. Well, I am still the champion. So let's see where we are now in terms of the town map. So now we're finally up in this area up here. So we are right now in the fight area, a tiny port town where trainers love battling more than eating to gather. And then apparently there's a Pokemon here. We also got a survival area. We got a resort area. And then up here, I guess, is the volcano, which is called Stark Mountain. Alright. Howdy, trainer. You have a Pokedex, do you? Here's my advice. Go out and challenge other trainers. They'll all have different Pokemon, so your Pokedex should fill up in no time flat. Howdy, trainer. Oh, wait. I bet the person who gave you that Pokedex is waiting for you to fill it completely. Well, I think I've only got a couple more to go, to be honest with you. Whenever I travel somewhere new, I get excited over what I might discover. But the places I've visited before, even those can thrill me with new discoveries. Yes, things can change from time to time. Your Pokemon are from Sinnoh, aren't they? We're used to seeing some of those kinds around here. Let's grab some berries while we're here. Hondu berries. I think, was this the Eevee berry that I was missing? Might have been. And what do we got over here? We got Pomeg berries, so another Ivy berry. Good. So I don't know exactly how long we're going to be here, but let's see. Let me look at my berries now. Let's sort them out. Oop, that's the wrong thing there. Keep going to the wrong folder here. Okay. So yeah, now I've got... it was... The one I'm missing is the Kelpsy berry, which I apparently don't see here. So, all right. Yeah, that's the last of the ivy berries that I'm missing. There are no pit stops on the road to toughness. I just made that up, but it sounds pretty cool, don't you think? Yeah, whatever. Volcanic activity has caused the land around here to become craggy. It's hard enough to hike over such rough terrain, even without all the ups and downs. Let's see what else is here. Maybe we can find some more stuff. He was one of those early eccentrics who were around during the first days of the battle zone. Well, I was too. I see you have a Torchic, one of the Hoenn starters. The battle zone used to attract only the hardiest of trainers. They were considered eccentric for gathering at a place like this. It's hard to believe how much has changed since then. Places like the fight area and the survival area just seem to spring up overnight. It's a nice little Torchic there. There's a lot of stuff here. Even from here, we can see the peak of Mount Coronet. Most people didn't notice what happened up there, but I did. But I don't know what took place exactly or anything like that. Well, if you got a few minutes, I'll tell you. Everyone's fanatical about battling. So we're probably going to be seeing a lot of battles. I mean, this place is called the Fight Area. The Pokemon Elite Elite Four come here sometimes. They're quite the bunch, I'll tell you that. So what are you selling? Nothing out of the ordinary, though you do have full restores. I've still got plenty of my things here, so I'm not going to bother with buying or selling anything here right now. I've battled many trainers over the years and I've gained confidence in my skills. But the world is still a huge place. In life, there's no such thing as an easy win. And it looks like this is the Battle Park. I guess we're looking for the Battle Tower. Let's go in and have a look at this. Welcome to the Battle Park. It's your first time, isn't it? Please step this way. Since this is your first visit, you need to be given a point card. Point cards are used only in the Battle Park. Here you go. So we got ourselves a point card. So I think you can exchange points for rare items. So now if I was to get into IV training, I think now would be the time to start racking up some points and eventually getting the items I need to train. If you need information on the point card, please ask the receptionist next to me. I'm the one you need to ask if you have information on the facilities here at the Battle Park. From information on the battle rules used at the Battle Park, please ask the receptionist across from me. Alright, well, let's have a look. I can give you a rundown of the battle rules that are used in the Battle Tower. Pokemon levels. In Pokemon battles at the Battle Tower, Pokemon that are level 51 or higher will be set to level 50 for the battles. That's fair. But be careful, Pokemon that are lower than level 50 will be left as is. That's not a problem for me, all my guys are at least level 60 right now. Species and numbers of Pokemon. Excluding eggs and certain exotic Pokemon, virtually every species of Pokemon may enter the Battle Tower. So I think they don't allow legendaries there. Please be aware that the number of Pokemon you may enter will depend on the course you try. You're also permitted to take only one of each kind of Pokemon into the Battle Tower, so no duplicates. And lastly, held items. No two Pokemon in your party can hold the same kind of item at the Battle Tower. Please be sure that the Pokemon you bring to the Battle Tower are all holding different items. That seems fair enough. Now, let's move on here. We're just saying welcome to the Battle Park. Let's have a look at the Battle Park. The types of Pokemon, the moves to be taught and used, the items to be held. To become number one here, there is no detail that can be overlooked. Ain't that the truth? Started as a simple game, and now it's evolved into this huge strategy contest. Ooh, found a Razor Fang. Let's see what else we got here. I heard that the world's best gather here for battles. This is my chance to get global fame and recognition. So, this is the exchange service corner, so this is where we can exchange our points. Looks like both these buildings are. Let's see what they have here. Do you see a little girl with her grandmother upstairs? That girl's a little terror in battle. You can never can judge people. Is that so? Let's see what you got here. So we get BP for... So we can get Calm Mind, Toxic, Bulk Up, Earthquake, a Shadow Ball, Brick Break, Sludge Bomb, Aerial Ace, Attract, Energy Ball, Dragon Pulse, Will-O-Wisp, Stone Edge, Thunder Wave, X-Scissor, Cut, Fly, Surf, Strength, Defog, Rock Smash, Waterfall, and Rock Climb. You need a lot of, looks like a lot of BP for this. I don't know how many BP you get for each battle here. What do you got? Ability patch, so you can make your Pokemon change abilities. They can switch abilities with that. Bottle cap. I know in Sword and Shield you would exchange these during hyper training to get the, when your Pokemon reaches level 100, you could actually use these bottle caps to max out their EV values. Or is it IV? I think it's IV battle. There are IVs that you can max out with one of these. There's also the gold one that will IV, they'll max out everything in terms of IVs. Sorry if I fumbled over my words there, but these are crucial with IV with EV training. I keep getting EV and IV mixed up, but you get what I mean there. You got rare candies, the vitamin items, lucky egg, which will double your experience. You get the power bracer and all these. For trying to actually train specific stats, you would use these items. When your Pokemon's wearing them, they will their speed will be cut in half during battle, but the growth on these will be enhanced depending on which one of these items you give. And then, of course, you got the EV berries. Makes it happy but lowers EV points if you need to take away some of the EV points that you've gotten. I did a, years ago, I did a Pokemon EV Training 101 around when the original Diamond and Pearl came out. So if you want to have a look at that, it's on my channel. It's one of my more popular videos, one of my more extensive projects, one of my ones I'm very proud of. A few orbs here. The White Herb, which will restore any lower stat in battle. The Mental Herb. Can shake off a move binding move. The Power Herb, one I like to combo with Solar Beam with Typhlosion and Heart Gold. But yeah, you can use a 2-turn attack in 1 turn with these. Bright Power for lowering accuracy. The choice options here, they'll boost certain stats, but you're limited to one move. And then you got the Focus Band, lets you survive certain attacks. Muscle Band doubles the EV points you get at the cost of half your speed. Scope Lens for critical hit ratio. I use this a lot in Unite. Light Clay to increase the length of light screen and reflect. Lucky Punch. Another Razor Claw. The Razor Fang. This can actually evolve Rhydon into Rhyperior. And I think a few of these can also do some upgrades as well. And you also got these Mints as well, which will actually change its nature. So if you want it to be a give it like a stronger attack but lesser a special attack, you give them the Adamant Mints. This essentially, yeah, change their nature. And there are a few. There's the Serious Mints, which is the neutral one. So there's a lot of items here. So yeah, it's probably gonna be a lot of stuff I might do off camera. What's this get today? Maybe perhaps Technical Machine will do. But yeah, I'll have to test out Battle Tower. I don't know if I'm going to have enough time to do it in this episode, but we'll see how much BP we can get. And then I could probably put together a solid, put the team that I have as the best possible stats as well. What the? Whoops, sorry about that. I was in a rush. Oh, wait a second, aren't you? You're T.U.G from Twinleaf. Wow, that brings back memories. So if you're here, he can't be far behind. This should be fun. See you. And who is that? People running into me. What the? Oh, hey, T.U.G, you came to the Battle Tower too, huh? I decided to see how I measure up before going to Stark Mountain. But that guy you were just talking to. Nah, it's alright, I got here on my own power. It won't take long before I see him. See you, T.U.G. I'm going to toughen up here. Although I don't think you actually get experience from these battles here. In the battle rooms, the 7th trait mirror you face is the room's boss. You need to stay focused if you want to win. Battle Tower. Gather all ye greatest. Well, why don't we give it a run and see what happens with this. And I believe all these battles are going to be 3-on-3 or something like that. They profile you on TV if you set a good record here. This is my only chance to regain my glory as an idol. You look like something of an expert, but you're just longing to know everything there is about Pokemon, right? Yes, I can tell just by looking at you. While you're in luck, I'd like to give you a present that will let you see straight through to a Pokemon's innate strengths. It's called the Judge Function. Ooh, I want one of these. After selecting a Pokemon in a box, press the plus or minus button to see its potential. With this, you will truly be an expert. So, I can now judge my Pokemon. Let's see. Did I get anything? View stats. Yeah, so now I can go into judge. And by doing this, I can see the individual individual potentials of my Pokemon. So let's see. Ideally, you want great or amazing stats, I believe. It goes okay, good, great, amazing, I believe is how we go here. I see I've got several good and a few great. Weavile is great. Roserade is good. Gyarados is just okay. Crobat's good. Garchomp is good. And Infernape, unfortunately, is only okay. So, out of all the Pokemon that I have, the IVs that are the strongest are on Weavile, believe it or not. So, I will definitely... Yeah, a lot of these Pokemon need work, but I'm curious to see how well this battle is going to go here. Excuse me, do you have a moment? Have you ever tried the Masterclass battles? Everyone's so strong in them, I can't win at all. Well, this is my first time here. Single, double, and their Masterclasses. If you win, you earn rare candies and BP. Okay. Well, let's try it out. I'm your guide to the single and double battle rooms. Yes, let's go ahead and do it. And you know what? I think we'll do double battles. Because I got a good combination I can use here. So I'm going to use my party as my battle team. And I'm going to bring in... Let's see. Crobat and Infernape to start. And let's see. Gyarados and Infernape. Yeah, everyone's been knocked down to level 50. So we'll see how this turns out. Now we got to save. So let's go ahead and do it. Now let's battle as many as I can without going too far over my limit here. Yeah, I don't know how long these individual battles are going to take or how many I'm going to go through. I think the magic number is 7 or something like that. But we'll see. And there's no guarantee I'll win them all. Because these guys are rather tricky from what I've heard. I might end up repeating some battles. La 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 la. That's all you gotta say? Alright. So let's test this out. Idol Selena. We'll start with Bagon and Chimecho. Start with a Psychic and a Dragon. Alright, so I have an idea of what I'm gonna do here. Let's U-turn on Chimecho and Earthquake everybody. Yeah, that's going to force me to switch out. But I do have Gyarados at the ready here, and that's who I'm going to bring in. So yeah, I don't think I'll be getting any experience from these battles. And I also don't think any Pokemon I meet here will go into my Pokedex either. So Chimecho was able to avoid Earthquake. Thanks to Levitate. That's fine. Use Uproar. Yeah, you don't get experience in these battles. So this is basically, I guess, kind of like exhibition battles. Bringing in a shield on now. Okay. Alright, so. Let's Waterfall Chimecho, and then we'll Earthquake everybody again. Gonna try Protect, huh? Anyway, use that move. So Earthquake's gonna miss entirely. You're stuck in Uproar for a while here, so I think it's like 3 turns. Or until you die. Down goes Chimecho. Now a Spoink coming in, a psychic type, okay. And we'll just see how Rock Slide works against these guys. Not really that well, it looks like. The Spoink flinched. Alright, let's go ahead and finish this guy off. The win. Bye bye, la la. Yeah, no money, no experience for these battles. You're just gonna get BP, I think. Is it after every battle or is it after every number of battles? Your Pokemon will be restored to full health. Thank you. Yeah, we start every. Okay, so we gotta keep battling. Alright. So I decided I didn't want to bore you with all these subpar battles here. We'll do the Battle Tower some other time here. Actually, I was having some technical issues here, so I had to kind of cut, and because I had to save beforehand, and unfortunately I couldn't just throw the take out and start afresh, so we'll do the Battle Tower some other time. So I will go ahead and I want to explore a bit more now, since we've got a little bit of time here. I think there was a route to the right that I could check out here. This is Route 230. Are we going to get some actual battles we can get experience in? Or right there, trainer. Have you been to the Battle Tower? It's a good place to learn useful battle techniques. You get to see all sorts of Pokemon and their moves also. Since you're here, you have the back. Yeah, I already know that thing, so. Oh, we got more berries up here. Ah, the Kelpsy berries. Finally found them. Great. I've been looking for these. So now I can probably hang out around here if I wanted to and just harvest a bunch of these when I decide to start EV training, if and when the time comes. But again, I want to focus on clearing everything out in terms of storyline. Is it going to let me across the river? No. Yeah, I've been to the Battle Tower. Do I gotta do something over here? Let's see. I'm a kid toting trainer. I want to show my beloved son something cool, so I'm having to go at a master class. So I don't know if they're forcing me to do Battle Tower or what. Mahaha, we earned a lot of BP at the Battle Tower. Now I'm going to change it for loads of prizes. So that's something we'll definitely want to go ahead and do at some point here. Yeah, I gave you guys a quick glance at it. I don't know if I actually have to do this or what, but if I can just maybe go on and go to the next route here. Tons of people in Pokemon Center. The best trainers gather here, not just from this region, but from all around the world. The Battle Tower is as tough as they say. It's no cakewalk, that's for sure. To strengthen myself, to strengthen my Pokemon. For that alone, I have come. I still want to look around and see if, do I have to do this, or... So these guys are definitely blocking the route here. I can't go in on a diagonal. Complete your Pokedex and turn in your report. Or maybe I gotta complete the Pokedex. Alright, so I may have got my, assignment for the next episode. So So I know there's a couple of Pokemon that I'm missing. So I think that may be what I want to do next. And now, oh yeah, now you can see my Pokemon that have made the Hall of Fame here. Yeah, I did the recording on December 28th. That's when I did this. I'm probably not, the episode's probably not airing until February. Anyway, Rowan's PC. 146 Pokemon. You're not far from seeing every Pokemon there is to see in Sinnoh. I think there's like five Pokemon that I haven't seen yet. So I'll have to look through my archives here and see what I'm missing. Again, I just have to see the Pokemon. I don't necessarily have to catch them. So I'm missing number 114. I may want to look this up in a encyclopedia here, or Wikipedia. Listed Generation 4 Pokemon. So it's the one after Snorlax. Munchlax or Snorlax? Actually, not giving me the one what I need here. So I'm looking for number 114, which is unknown. So I have to go back into wherever that nursery was to check out those ruins. Who else? Missing 146, 147, and 148, which is Uxie, Mesprin, Azelf, and then of course I got Palkia, which I don't know if I can actually, where am I going to be able to actually see that, I wonder. I don't know, I'll have to look at it. But we may be doing some legendary hunting in the next episode. Because, yeah, these guys are not going to let me up to 229 either. So, yeah, they're saying I need to fulfill the Pokedex completely as well. So, I think I'm going to go ahead and head back to Sinnoh then. Take me back. We'll worry about the Battle Tower some other time. I just want to give you a little taste of what's to come there. But if you're willing to put the time and effort to EV train, then that would be where you'd want to go. Alright, so anyways, so where are those ruins again? I think they were in here, which is Celestion Town. Makes sense, because, yeah, the ruins are right to the side, if I'm not mistaken. Is this the right place? Gotta be. I'll have to double check. So this way I can look and find some unknown here. Weavile does have false swipes, so it'd be pretty easy to catch at least one of them. But yeah, if I go all the way to the east, yeah, this is it. This is it. But if I go all the way east here, then this will take me into the ruins where we can find unknown. Okay, so I think I have a battle plan for our next episode then. So I guess at this point, I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here. Gave you guys a little bit of the taste of the fight area and the battle tower. Like I said, I'm sorry for the technical difficulties, but I had to do what I got to do there. But we now have our objective for next episode. We're going to start catching some, hopefully, some legendary Pokemon. So until next time, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.